Hey y'all, welcome back. This is Cynthia Faith, the owner of Boss Nails Divine. Today we're going to be recreating the super cute press-on set I have available on my TikTok shop. If you want to purchase this set, click the link in my bio, but we're going to hop straight into how I create this set. I start by applying nail primer to my nail tips. Apply this in a straight up and down motion, not side by side, because it will affect how your gel lays on the nail. I'm using a thin liner brush for my gel application on the orange, so this is how I have to do the French tip. I am going to be going over this neon orange gel with pigment powder because I need it to be very, very neon. If you want to check out how I do my French tip design, click the link in my description to see my first nail video. Before I apply the pigment powder, I go in with base coat because this just helps it adhere a lot better. Although there is already a tacky layer from my gel application, I like to go over with base coat. I do two coats of the black so that way I just have that really nice black effect on the nails. Now we're going to apply the neon powder over these orange nails. Now this, I did start off with a sponge, but I noticed the sponge was giving a weird layer. It wasn't super smooth, so I end up going over it with a brush. Y'all, this pigment powder is very, very loose, so make sure you have some type of air purifier to get up all that extra dust. You do not want to breathe this in. For the neon nails, I did apply a layer of base coat so that way the designs lay very, very smooth and I don't have any bumps. You want to make sure you use a thin layer of gel whenever you do these designs. If you're a nail tech watching this, let me know in the comment section some of your favorite products and tips and tricks you have when creating nail art on nails. Especially for the checkered effect, I need a very thin layer of black gel so that way it doesn't bubble up in my light. This checkered effect is pretty easy. I use that first checkered box to lay out the rest of my boxes. I really, really love this design. When I made this, I just love doing checkered nails, so I had to add this to the nail set. If you create press-on nails, I would love to know some of your favorite designs that you've done recently and what designs you would really like to tap into more. I'm super interested to know. If you have a nail business that you run, make sure you tag it in the comment section so I can follow you as well. So, when I was designing the thumbs, I realized that whoever manufactured these nails ended up putting number 2 on the thumbs, but one of the thumbs is clearly not a 2. It was giving more of a 3 or a 4, and this is a big problem if I was going to give this to my client because her thumbs would not fit. So, I'm glad I noticed that before I finished designing. You want to make sure that you're very, very thorough when you are creating these nails and you make sure that each size is actually the right size and you compare all the sizes just to make sure that each size is going to fit the same way. For the croc design, I did add a thin layer of blooming gel. I like to make the design drag off from the sides. You also want to make sure that you're applying a thin layer of gel polish so that way it doesn't bubble up in the light when you do cure this. I've noticed I did get a lot of bubble up when I would do this design in white, so I just have to make sure that my gel is mixed properly and I use a very thin layer. With the croc design, you want to make sure you give yourself enough space in between each line just so that way it looks croc, and don't be afraid to wipe it off and start over if it doesn't look right. I've had to start over, wipe it away many of times just because it wasn't given croc design, but you just want to make sure you really take your time with this. Now I'm picking out my Playboy stickers. This is actually the very key part to this nail set is the Playboy nails. People really do look forward to that Playboy design in the nails. When I did post it to TikTok shop, I had to make sure that I took the Playboy design and put a little box over it because you do get copyrighted when you use other brands' stickers or logos when you try to resell things. I didn't have that problem on Mercari, but for TikTok shop, they do make sure that you're not using the likeness of other brands when you're promoting your product. For the French design, I like to go in with this tan nude, but I'm going to be adding a pink nude over it. This tan nude just helps me get that full coverage in this pink top coat that I love so much. This pink top coat is a top coat, so you don't need a top coat on top of it, but as you can see, it gives you that really cute nude. I use it in my hand to the right, not the hand to the left. I absolutely love this nude top coat. I was so happy when I found out about it. I get it every time I go to the nail supply store. So I'm gonna add one layer and show y'all what that looks like. As you can see, it gave it a nice pink tint compared to that tan color, and I like to add that tan underneath it because this is a very sheer. On the top is two coats and on the bottom is only one coat, so I did go in with two coats just to give it that really nice nude pink coverage. This nude pink is what really sets off the nails as well. It works and looks beautiful on any skin tone, so I definitely recommend getting this nude pink color. I go over it with this top coat by iBeauty. I actually really love it. If you're someone who creates 3D water nails, this is not a strong top coat, if you know what I mean. It's not super strong, but it works very beautiful and feels very smooth on my nails. I haven't had any smudging. I use this nail rhinestone glue I got from Shein. I actually really love it. If you haven't seen my Shein haul, make sure you check it out. But I like to go ahead and add the glue to my nails. Normally I use a brush. I apply the glue to a brush and then apply it to my nails, so I'm not using an excessive amount of glue. But I just went ahead and applied it straight to the nails. In 2024, y'all, I definitely plan on collaborating with more nail techs to give y'all some nice, fun interviews and Q&As and more content that y'all can relate to, especially in this very competitive industry. I use this nice rhinestone picker-upper I got from Shein. I do know that you can buy different wax heads to replace these if it does get low. These jewels are very pretty. I got this from my local beauty supply store for about $46. I'm gonna go ahead and use these small little circle charms because I noticed that the other ones I have weren't the same quality as these. These kind of give off like a Swarovski crystal vibe, but they're not Swarovski crystal. They're just regular glass crystals, but I really love them. They have a really nice high shine. With these jewelry cases, you want to make sure that they're flat at all times because now that I opened up these circle charms, I don't want them to go everywhere in the box. You know what I mean? If you know, you know. On another note, I do want to let y'all know I will be posting more videos about how to become a press-on nail seller, even if you're just starting out with zero followers, and giving more advice on how to gain your following on TikTok and Instagram, and really helping y'all just sell press-on nails and get started in the business. Now, it does seem like all this stuff is super expensive, but if you just start slow and work your way up, you'll definitely be very successful in selling press-on nails. I absolutely love this. You get the convenience of working from home and being your own boss, and I really love that, and I want that for everybody. So if I can tell y'all all my tips and tricks, I will. This is what the charms are giving. They're just really beautiful, that high shine. I absolutely love them. With the checker design, I like to add the jewels and the black squares, and then I'm gonna go in with some pearls and add it to the orange squares. I think this design on the nails is what really makes it pop and what people love the most. It's just very different. I haven't seen this done before. When I made the set, I was just freestyling. You want to make sure that the glue is also around the sides of the charm. You can go in with a small brush just to reinforce that glue, so that way it adheres perfectly and none of the charms fall off. I haven't had any problems with this nail glue I got from Shein, the gem charm glue that I got from Shein. It's actually been very strong. I haven't had any problems with any gems falling off. If you're wondering how I know my client's nail size, I have them send me a picture of their hand next to a coin, and that's how I'm able to get the perfect sizing trick. Please let me know in the comments if y'all want a tutorial on that. Shout out to the person who invented the coin sizing trick, because I definitely didn't invent it. It's super, super smart and changed the whole nail game. Before the nail sizing trick came along, you used to have to purchase a clear nail set, and that would range from anywhere from $5 to $10. For the Playboy nails, I'm gonna do like a freestyle jewel effect. I add like a big jewel and I add some different small jewels on the bottom. You'll see what I mean. If you're a nail tech, I would love to know your goals for your nail business. Me personally, I would love to just design for people who go to Met Galas and fashion shows and who are just very busy people out in the limelight, like radio talk show hosts and people who just go out a lot. Like, I would just love to design nails for people who are different and just have different creative ideas. I love to take on new tasks with creating different nail designs for like artists. If they have a new song out, I would love to create an art piece that just represents their vision. In 2024, I definitely plan to just get more creative with my nail designs. I personally love the sky and nature, so I am so obsessed with sky vibes and just that really nice different color tone palette. So I can't wait for y'all to see what we do in 2024. For the size of the jewels, I went in with really small little circle charms, so that way like it's not awkwardly a whole bunch of glue on the sides. You want to make sure that you are very mindful of that, because it gives the nails a lot of cleaner effect if you can go in with some small little circle charms on the sides of your charms. I did mess up on the nails a little bit, so I added these little charms on the squiggly lines and dotted lines, so that way you can't see where I messed up at. For the croc nails, I did this really beautiful necklace effect, which is basically adding big jewels that go from bigger to smaller as you get down to the cuticle nails. When I first started doing nails, I would do acrylic nails on actual people. And now that I discovered press-on nails after the pandemic, I am safe to say that I do not miss doing acrylic nails. Now, I love the people interaction, but truly, you have to be a certified nail tech to really get into doing acrylic nails. And if you're not a certified nail tech right now, make sure that you take some nail courses and you really, really find out the safety of doing acrylic nails, because looking back, you just want to make sure that you do everything right and you're very sanitizing. Like, there's so many details that go into doing actual acrylics on different people, so you want to be safe and you want to do it the right way. If you're on TikTok, I found this really dope nail instructor called Mary Negra School of Nails. She is a nail coach, actually a nail teacher, who goes live on TikTok and teaches y'all while she's teaching her class. You do have to pay to see certain demonstrations that she does, but it's very, very informal if you're someone who wants to do acrylic nails but haven't gone to school yet. I also plan on dropping videos to help y'all find out about creating brand ambassadors for your nails. Now, I have scouted out one person to be my brand ambassador this year. Next year, I plan on scouting out a few more girls. The brand ambassador I picked has actually helped my business grow tremendously. Y'all, I literally made this set while I was on my way to a pool party she invited me to, and that video went viral. It gained me about 3,000 followers. I had over 2,000 in TikTok sales. So I definitely picked the right brand ambassador. Now, I had to put in all the hard work. I'm the one who put in the talent, but having someone who can help encourage you to continue creating while you're not getting many customers is very, very important to keep going in this business, because there are going to be slow times, but you want to make sure that your creative drive just keeps going and that you keep putting in that work. Now, although I said find a brand ambassador, that does not mean give products away for free. I feel like in the nail community, we do offer a lot of free services. We discount ourselves a lot, but you have to keep your foot on the gas. No matter where you're starting, you're still worth something, even if you have 0 followers to 1,000 followers. And always remember, each time you practice, that adds to your experience. I've been in this nail game for about 6 years now, so my quality of work is worth a lot more than what I'm selling it for right now. But just always believe in yourself, keep practicing, and keep putting in those hours. I promise you, it's a lot easier than it seems, but it does get a lot easier if you just keep practicing and you always keep learning. There's always room to learn and grow. Uniqueness does help you stick out in this industry, but remember, there's over 1 billion people in this world, and nails is something people will always buy, always want, no matter what. You can be selling the same thing as 100 different people, but I promise you, somebody's gonna like your work. Someone's gonna want your work. But I say all of that to say, make sure you do stick out and you're very, very different from everybody else. I've never seen a nail set like this on the market before. And every time I go into Walmart, I always check out the cheap little press-on nails to see if they stole my design. But hey, But at the same time, I don't have a patent for this design, so anybody can recreate this, and I don't have a problem with that. You just want to make sure that you just continue to market yourself and find different ways to be different and to stick out from the crowd. I'm still working on getting better packaging for my nails, but I just use these paint swatches I find at Walmart. They're 100% free, and I pretty much just write my name, my business name, Boss Nails Divine, on them, and I also write the person's initials of who they're going to. This just makes it easier for when I'm ready to ship, so I can just keep track of whose nails these are. I also write thank you on the cards and my nail name, like I just said, so that way they know who they got them from, and that way they know where who to write the review for. Sometimes people just buy a whole bunch of nails at once and don't know who they bought them from. To stick the nails on the cards, I use double-sided tape. Y'all know this tape does get pretty expensive if you are a nail tech, so I literally don't need a lot. I need about that much, because this tape is actually very, very stretchy. So I make it stretch. I use about half of the size of the card, and then I go ahead and cut it and stretch it to the other side of the card. This is just a really great way to help you save money when you are using this tape. I also like to keep it in the packaging, so that way a whole bunch of lint or hair doesn't stick to the nail tape. Because what you don't want is you don't want any of your nails to have hair on them. I always make sure I'm not selling any of my products with hair attached to it or lint attached to it. I'm just superstitious like that. Today. I'm gonna go ahead and stick the nails on here before I file them, so that way I can just get them out the way. I also have like 3 other sets to do, so I'm just gonna stick them on here and file them down before I ship them. This just helps me save time to just move on to the next set without having a whole bunch of dust on my hands or anything like that. You also want to make sure that you take off any of that double-sided glue that I had on my nail stands that are on the back of the nail. You want to make sure you remove all of that because your client might not know what that is and get really freaked out, like, what is this on the back of my nails? Before I ship the nails as well, I like to clean them with alcohol just to remove any of those fingerprints that may be on my nail from sticking them on there. So using gloves is very recommended when you are doing this. And this is what our beautiful press-on nail set looks like. I hope y'all enjoyed this video. Make sure you follow me for more nail videos. I have a whole bunch of nail shorts creating a whole bunch of different designs. This set is available in different colors. This is my first time doing the orange nails. If you want to make your nail tips smell good, I like to go in with this nail drying spray. This is for like nail polish. It just gives your nails a nice shine and also gives them like a nice coconut scent. Your buyer will definitely appreciate the scented nails. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you follow me, leave a comment of what tips we should do next, and go ahead and subscribe. I'll see y'all later.